Yeah, this is the WL Toys A979B, and we broke it. Okay, I broke it. I must admit, but yeah. So, now let's tell you the story of how it happened.
Yeah.
Okay, so what happened was, I was driving, there's this corner over there where the driveway meets the sidewalk, and the throttle stuck, and I was going at full speed, and so it just smashed right into there. I could have turned, I must admit. Okay, so I must admit I wasn't being really careful or anything, but yeah, I'm gonna be much more careful in the future. But today we are going to be fixing this up.
And I'm gonna be fixing it.
So what actually happened was the chassis bent from the power, but since it's plastic, it bent back. But it bent the transmission shaft too.
Yeah.
So.
But then since that's made out of aluminum, it did not bend back. And then it was hitting the ESC every time and like bent.
And
in,
it like wouldn't move, and it would make like this grindy sound.
Like,
So we just need to fix it.
It was really bad because I was holding the car, and he like started up. It almost fell out of my hand. It was shaking so much.
Yeah. So now we're gonna be fixing that. Let's go.
This is what I've done so far. So I've removed the transmission cover line. That's not the proper term for it. But I've taken that off, and then inside, there's this little piece, and that goes over the ball bearing that's right there. I don't know if you can see that on camera.
Yep, right there. Right in front of that. What's it called? Yeah, I can't remember the name of that gear. It's called the reduction gear, yes.
So I've removed that, and this car is very easy to take apart. I'm surprised. There are a lot of pieces that aren't even screwed in place. Like, for instance, this. There are holes in the top. There are holes in the top, so you'd assume there'd be screws.
Yeah.
But there's no screws. I literally just pulled this out. That's all you have to do. I don't even know what's holding that in. So everything actually does have screws in it. I've just already unscrewed them.
And we haven't actually showed you how bad this looks, but you can see this is actually, show a side angle. It's, like, actually, curved.
Big time curved.
Yeah, and if I...
Every time it runs, it bangs up against the ESC, and you can actually see the ESC, backwards.
And you can actually see a couple marks in there if you look closely.
Yes. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to be removing the differential. So to do that, just to make it easier, I'm going to be removing just the top portion of the suspension with just an Allen wrench, and I'm not sure what's the size of this. This is a 1/7 or something.
Yeah. So this is actually my RC car, so it's a little uncomfortable with him taking it apart.
Yes, but what we made a deal, so if I break it, then I'd pay for whatever it is to be fixed by professionals,
like which a hobby town or something.
Yeah, I must admit that I am not a professional.
No.
I hate to say
it. Also, we are not using our microphones right now. I have no idea why. It doesn't really matter, though. They haven't been working very well recently.
So if you bought them and you've had the same issue, tell us in the comments, because we want to know if it's just a bad microphone or if we just picked up it.
Because it was only $9.
It was pretty cheap.
It was originally $35 or something, though. Also, there's a link to the microphone in the description.
Here, okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and pry off these suspension and just toss those aside, because they're really...
Don't pay attention to that sound.
They're really pointless. And I'm going to go ahead and remove the wheels. Yes, okay. For a second, I thought I lost the screw. So they're starting to pile up just pieces over in the corner, which looks really cool. I'll show that to you afterward, because it looks like, you know, professional people that take apart their RC cars completely and do cool stuff. So I'm removing these wheels, so then I can easier unscrew these like wheel stabilization things. And I'm sorry that I can't name everything with the correct name, I'd have to look at the manual to do that.
I'm not gonna
pause every time to look at the manual. So I'm just gonna call them what they like their point.
What he thinks they're called,
which is usually the wrong thing.
Yeah,
except for a few things, because I studied my manual. Okay.
Here we go. This is crazy seeing it all taken apart.
I know, it's cool though, isn't it?
Uh-huh. And also, I have a question for everybody out in the comment section world. Do you think we should have better quality in our videos? Because I'm just wondering this. I mean, obviously, if we had better quality in our videos, I'd be like, awesome. But do you actually, like, really think we should?
Use the drive shaft. See, I know what that's called. Are you guys proud of me or what? So now that's just limp there. No, I've done this a lot before because on my A959B, I've put bearings in. And so I've taken all this apart before. And I know one thing, just a tip. If you're going to put bearings in your RC car, always remember to put your drive shafts in. Because I probably did that 3 times where I just attached this back on without putting the drive shaft in. And then I had to take it all apart again. And it was so frustrating. Like, so frustrating. Okay, here we go. Just these 2 screws.
Taught this angle a little bit. You can see how this is, like, just bending.
Yeah. So these, I just gotta unscrew these 2 screws, and then the differential should just pop apart.
Hopefully he'll be able to put this back.
I will. Are we ready? Let's see if it comes. Yep. Nice. Yeah, I have to be really careful with the differential because it's very
important.
It's fine.
Okay, I thought that was
so. Guys, if you ever wondered what a differential looked like,
there you looks go. Like.
So that's just the outside, but you know. Yeah. So here's the differential. See, there we go. So I'm just going to put all this off to... Look how dangly.
It's so, like, clumsy.
I know. You don't realize... Okay, so I'm going to put that differential over there. Now, you can see the drive shaft is starting to come out. I just need to do the same thing on the other side. Oh, my gosh.
So,
oh, my gosh.
Yeah, we're just going to...
This is going to take a while. Yeah. Here, look.
We're just going to cut
ready,
right to this
three,
part.
3, 2, 1.
So, now we're taking this off.
Whoa.
That falls out every single time.
Okay. Here's the rear differential, so they're the exact same.
Set that over. Wait. Here she is. Now so, you can see how badly bent that is.
Yep. So that's really, yeah.
Yeah,
that's
now not, I'm just regretting.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Here's the car without wheels, suspension, differentials, drive shafts, transmission covers.
Sorry about the dog. Yeah,
practically everything. So yeah. We're going to try and bend this back and then see if it works. And if it doesn't, we're going to be getting a new transmission line for this.
So,
and
yeah.
Then we'll show you how to install.
So yeah, let's go. Okay, so I'm in my garage right now, and now I'm going to try to bend this back with the hammer. Secret. Okay, hopefully nothing bad happens. See if you can see that. Here we go. That almost completely just bent perfectly back. So I'm going to try a little more, and then we're going to start putting it right back in the car. This is the best I could get it, which is pretty good in my opinion. That is as straight as I could get it. Hopefully it'll still work, and if it doesn't, this is going to suck, and I'm going to need to get a new one. Luckily, they're only like $9 though, so yeah. All right, now we're going to fix it up. And let's see if this works. Let's go. So we just put this in, and it fits perfectly. It's not bent anywhere.
And I'm turning the motor here, and it's rotating it. And it is still slightly bent, so we still may get a new one just to be safe. But it's working pretty good so far, and it'll just be good just to keep in there until we can get a new one, so then we'll be able to drive it.
Now we're going to have a time-lapse in 3, 2, 1. Okay, so the first differential is in place.
And it's working fine. So see, it's rotating
this one side because I haven't put in the drive shaft on the other side. So I'm really feeling good about this. At the beginning, I must admit, I was a little scared because this isn't my car. I was going to break it, and then I'd have to pay for it to be fixed by a professional. But now that the first differential's in, I'm going to be able to put in the rear differential.
But yeah, I'm really time lapse. 3, 2, 1.
So I have the front part completely assembled now, and I wanted to say it because it looks funny. Because look at it, it's just like the front's complete, back is just like nothing.
Okay, guys, so it works.
I put it back together, and I don't have the covers over, but this is the same thing. So each differential is rolling fine, and the drive shaft is rolling properly. So if you do this at home, like this is sort of a tutorial, like if this happens to you or something, then it will shake slightly, like when you're doing top speed, because this bar isn't exactly straight. And it may not deliver the torque as well as it used to, but it'll probably such like a minuscule difference, you'll probably hardly even notice it. But I'm so happy, because this is the first time I've taken apart all of this stuff. Like, everything I took apart in this video, I've never taken apart before. So I'm just so glad.
She didn't really tell me until just now, but
yeah, I didn't tell him because he wouldn't have let me do it, and I really wanted to do it.
Okay, so now we're gonna cut to where we have everything put together, and we're gonna just do a little test run
just to show you guys how amazing this works.
So let's go. Okay, now we are outside, and we are gonna test to see if this baby works.
I really hope it does because I put so much time.
Yeah. Yep. So let's go. Okay, we're gonna get all set up.
And we're not going to drive it very fast since this isn't waterproof, because we don't want any water to get in, especially just as we've fixed it, which is I fixed it.
Yeah.
So we're just going to take it around.
See if she works.
Yep.
Oh my goodness. It's huge. Oh, it sounds good. Okay, that's good.
Does it sound normal?
Yeah. Yep. It's just slipping a little bit on this.
Number one. Oh, get out of the grass. Don't drive it in the grass. Yeah, this car is sort of cheap, so we don't want to just drive it in the grass because we don't know how water.
This is super. It rained a little bit, so we're not gonna do this much. I'm just realizing how wet it is.
We're just doing this at our own risk, so don't try this at home.
Now he's driving it.
Whoa, you're.
Right. I know it's getting a bunch of wet. But yeah.
It sounds really smooth though.
I know it does. Thank you so much. I'm really happy.
Yeah, I'm just gonna get it trimmed up really quick because it's really bad. Holy smokes, that's really bad.
I need to see our tripod over there.
But yeah, so that it's doing pretty well.
Oh, it started to dry off and get grip, and I just felt it starting to pull. Whoa, they just spun out. That was awesome.
So now we fixed it, and yeah.
So it's working fine, and I am so happy because this requires so much work. So if you're ever gonna do this, this is more of like a how-to do, like if you wanted to switch your differentials out or something, this would be how to do it, and your drive shafts and everything. So this was a really easy fix. It just looked a lot harder because there were so many little bitty pieces.
I promise you all out there, I will be much more careful with my RC.
If he breaks it again, I will fix it, unless I can't fix it, but
yeah.
I may charge him next time. Comment down below on if you have this car. And if you've had any issues with it, please tell us. And on the slight chance that we know how to fix it, I'll reply to that to tell you. And if you have one at all, just comment down below and see if you love it. Or if you have any RC car, comment down below. If you have a pair of eyebrows, you can comment down below.
Yep.
Or if you're a human, you can comment down below.
And also if you wear shoes with shoelaces,
but if you have Velcro,
don't comment. No,
because you gotta subscribe.
Okay. Yeah, you have to. I mean, it's like that's not it. Really.
And then now you guys get to watch me sing a song. Well, he's inside. I'm gonna sing a little dandy song. Oh, on the prairie in the sun. Oh, oh, oh. There's a boy who lives in Tennessee. Alright, alright. He knows to be happy in 100 ways.